I guess, and welcome back to Demon Supremacic 2. Seems like we're in a bad situation there in prison with our skeleton friend there. And someone is coming to execute us, I guess. Sounds bad. Too bad for this imp that Doomga is the master of fist fighting. As you can see, we lost all our weapons and equipment. But we get back, them back eventually, don't worry. Take. It's good to see a map like this when you start with almost nothing. You have to scavenge stuff, be wary of your ammo usage, and fight lesser enemies again. Here we get our blizzard back. Back. Not back, but got it. We can punch things, and this is excellent. Weapon interior, as I say. Also, you can see that there's a new Gibbs, which are pretty awesome to say. Look at this. You don't need rivers of blood to make awesome death, just nice Gibb animations. This is kind of suspicious. This room right there can be a little trouble. These two shotgun guys can wreck you if you try to fist them and miss a few times. Nothing too terrible there. We get a chainsaw back, but why would you use a chainsaw when you have a burlock fist? Look, this guy got killed in one hit. That's how powerful the fist is. What's this? Secretaries, huh? Open that suspicious door there, and we got our super shotgun back. Excellent. Here's another secret switch. That's not that obvious. You can easily miss it. And opens this secret elevator there that leads much further into the level. I won't take it, because that would be problematic. Like, second breaks the level and you can miss a few weapons, which is very bad. Let's keep on moving instead. The safe scroll have placed a very good location. Site are not placed as time someone appears, I placed just before that. Like it's placed just before you get to that switch. So you don't like again like intenti or some other things. But to save at a point where you might be killed. Which is very retarded. And you can see well, yeah, don't have much ammo. You have to use your fist and make efficient use of your current ammo. If you don't have any ammo to kill these guys, you might be in trouble. Right there can be very tricky. There's quite a lot of enemies and you still don't have much ammo. Like, not even 40 shotgun shells. You don't have any other weapons. So you have to make very careful use of what you have and try to make the enemies in fight. There's some revenants back there. Lost Souls, Geckos, Imps. This can be very bad, especially if you didn't use all your ammo previously. Can be especially deadly at this stage. You don't have any armor. Elf is very scary at this point, so you have to really watch out. You can rush for this plasma again, but yeah, that can be dangerous if you're not good at dodging revenants. We have to press a switch to open these bars to progress. We get our rocket launcher back already. And we make use of it just right there. This level escalates very fast, like already we were fighting revenants and knights and even monkey back. While just a few minutes later, previously we were fighting just zombie men and a few demons. I believe this part is the only part in the world mode where you can fall to your death instantly. This is only instant death piece. And I love that one. You have to keep a few rockets for that. Take some right there and the left, but it's so good. Keeps everywhere. You feel so powerful when you get in situations like this. Most wise, you get a rocket launcher, you never get good situations like this when you can kill so much guys in a such short amount of time. Auto-scroll save. Sounds like a bad thing's coming. And yeah, this is kinda deadly. If you get stuck between the Rattnotrons and the Kakos, you will die. So my recommendation is to kill the Rattnotrons as soon as possible, then deal with the Kakos inside if possible. Kakos are very annoying outside because they go flying backward and you can't really get close to them because they're over nothing. It's best to lure them out, to lure them in, so they are easier to kill. And this level looks nice, it's pretty grey and brown again, but pretty nice use of lightning. We get specters in dark locations and some other things. And some secret accusers that aren't too hard to find. I found most of them in my first try. So this part I'm going back because this is a point where the secret we found before lead us. You have to do some backtracking to use this secret. I found this secret pretty bad because if you take it when you find it, you will miss weapons and you can be overwhelmed and lost. And if you want to use it after that, you have to backtrack. This elevator takes some time. That's the only bad design thing I found. I found that in this mode and the previous encounter in map 2 that dragged on too long. But you can somewhat sequence break by going that and there and skipping some areas. But you really need the rocket launcher and the plasma guns. If you know they're there, you can just take them and move on. But if you don't, you will be annoyed because you won't have weapons to deal what's coming next. Yeah, this bars. So we'll be gone if you take this secret before coming there. What thing about secrets? Secrets are good when you know they're actually there. Like, right here, there's a secret. Bandits. This blue armor, you can see it's there. You know there's a secret in this area and you can get to it. It's much better than secrets where you can never find because you have no idea there's even a secret in the current area. Secret was which are opened by switch on the other side of the map are kinda bad too. And this mode does a few. But this armor is coming in handy. Because for the next part, I don't think you can go back after you get in. And we're outside. The door closed bandits, so we can go back in. So we have to fight our way out. It's always pretty nice with these pillars provide cover for you. There's plenty of ammo to be found around. I mean, some plasma ammo, that is. This lava is also non insta death. Again, which is good. It's not good when you stand in it, but you won't die if you just trip 1 foot into it. And that's a suspicious wall again. So you know there's a secret in this area. You know it. You just have to find the switch. Or something else that's fine. So it's not that obvious now. Switch is literally done, we'll get to it. And we're pretty much stuck on weapons now. We have everything but the BFG, and we don't get the BFG in this mode again. That would make things a little too easier. Again, a suspicious wall. And this is a trap. Pretty damn trap. If you let this Mancubi block your way, you'll be stuck between these two packs, and that can be, again, very bad for you. If you know what's coming, you should get out as soon as possible. Yeah, after you kill this Mancubi, just El Niger just dead meat against your rocket launcher. We got our backpack. Back. I mean, at least. That was really useful at this point, but that was good to have. Free ammo and some max capacity. And you can see these revenants coming. It didn't mean these pillars. So if you didn't find the secret to start level, this is where you get the super shotgun. So you will run into these two guys, and that can be too bad for you. And oh! Yep. You can't have a good Doom 1 without at least one Cyber Demon in it. Oh well. So this one guy can be too tricky. What you want to do is clear up the Mancubi first, so you don't get picked off or shot in the back while you're fighting the Cyber Demon. You can try to make them in fight, but it's really not effective because of the pillars blocking the shot. Both theirs and the Cyber Demons. They are really good at throwing at you. You can go back through there, so the only thing you can do is go down there with already the Cyber Demon. This Cyber Demon's fight is quite easy. You have plenty of plasma. You have to watch out for the lava and the pillars though, but they provide you from cover if you need to hide. Not too bad, it goes down easily. Again, watch out for splash damage, that might kill you. Now for that secret we saw behind, you have to process with just behind there. It's not really obvious, but it's plausible. And you get a good reward of it. Megasphere, you get all your health back. So working in the lava is negated. Now we get into the last part of the level, which is pretty tough. Here I'm trying to make some infighting and not doing so good. There's Arcanicrons, Revenants, Barons. There's a lot of guys around and you don't have much room to dodge and so on. So what you do is kill some of these guys as fast as possible and run to work this way. That fight can be pretty dangerous, but if you press again, you should take it down easily. This secret is looking obvious. It's a location where you think a secret could be. And it comes really handy for this particular fight, because you get so much plasma. At this point, you can just use your big weapons and destroy everything. You don't have to care that much about ammo. Which feels good for once. These geckos can be annoying, but they're stuck in this, so they can't really dodge that much and move too far from you. So right, we cleared everything. We move on to this elevator there. But something bad happened. Okay, we're stuck there. You have to shoot these switches until you get the right choices. There's no way to tell which switches are good. You just have to try them out randomly. Meanwhile, lava is rising up. So you have to be fast. I get quite lucky there, but yeah, that might die, and this, you will probably need this autosave scroll. And so we escaped this trap. I will see you for the final level of Demon's Infirmity 2 next time. See ya!